The original Honda Fit was a prodigy when it burst onto the US car scene as a 2007 model. With vivid personality, an athletic chassis, and stunning space efficiency, it immediately embarked on a charm campaign that would win comparison test after comparison test, as well as a Car and Driver 10 Best Cars trophy for 7 consecutive years, well into its second generation. Alas, the latest Fit has been good if not quite great, handsomer than ever but sorely lacking its predecessor's eagerness, dynamic refinement, and user-friendliness. Our 40,000-mile long-term 2015 Fit earned no shortage of complaints involving its unrelenting buzz at highway speeds, its tiny gas tank, the fussy infotainment system that lacked a volume knob, and lessened fun compared with its predecessors. Now a thorough mid-cycle enhancement for 2018 gives this third-generation Fit a second chance to make a first impression. For 2018, Honda aimed to hone the Fit's chassis to quell bobbing, reduce noise levels, enhance the steering's linearity, and elevate its overall sense of nimbleness. Honda added structural braces around and under the body, swapped the shell-style steering pinion bearing for a solid one, and installed retuned dampers. It also used thicker acoustic materials inside the doors, wheel arches, and pillars, while new layers of soundproofing materials pad the dashboard and the floor. To reduce wind noise, the new Fit gets an acoustically insulating windshield and thicker front quarter windows. Remarkably, despite these refinements, weight is essentially a wash between the new and old cars, according to Honda. Without a pre-refresh Fit on hand for comparison, it's hard to measure the extent to which Honda achieved its ambitions. We can say, however, that the 2018 Fit XL we drove felt focused and planted as we swept along the Santa Clarita Valley's rolling two-laners. As we hurled the Fit into tight corners, its body stayed calm and the 185/55R16 all-season Firestone FR740 tires generally remained glued to the pavement before gently breaking away into predictable understeer at the limit. Little additional steering feel seems to have resulted from the updates, unfortunately, yet the Fit traced our intended line with utter precision. All the while, it rode with suppleness and composure, more like a Civic sedan than a stubby hatchback. Honda declined to tell us how much its accessory packages will cost at this point. But we do know that the 2018 Fit sticker prices are between $100 and $160 higher than last year, depending on trim. Base LX models start at $17,065, Sport models come in at $18,375, and X models cost $19,035, all with the manual transmission. Another $800 will equip any of those with a CVT automatic, while the Honda Sensing driver aids will cost LX and Sport customers another $1,000. As mentioned, Honda Sensing is included on the Fit X, even with the stick shift, as well as on the $21,395 XL model, the latter offered only with the CVT.
Rob Stone, two damn phones, Babylon's came.